Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at 8 different ways that you can handle Microsoft Word documents on your Mac. MacMost is made possible because of a great group of supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content. So I get asked by people all the time about how they can handle Microsoft Word documents on their Mac. They need to either open them, they need to be able to edit them, they need to be able to create them, collaborate with other people using Word either on Windows or Mac. Well, there are more ways than most people realize for handling Word documents on your Mac. It's just a matter of figuring out the right one for you. By far the best way, both in quality and ease of use, to handle Word documents on your Mac is to simply get Word. There's still some people that don't even realize that you can get Microsoft Word for Mac, even though it's always been an option. And actually it's easier now than ever because you can get it in the Mac App Store. That's right, if you go into the Mac App Store and search for Word, it will come up. And it appears even to be free. But there's a catch, and I'll get to that in a minute. So downloading Word from the App Store is kind of new, and it has a huge advantage over getting it from Microsoft or any other way, and that is that the updates are a lot easier to deal with. It's just updated through the Mac App Store. If you get it from Microsoft, you end up with this Office updater and it's always running and it seems like there's always these little updates, and it's just not as nice as getting it from the App Store. You can get Word, Excel, and other Microsoft apps from the App Store. And once you have Word, you've got maximum compatibility with Word documents. So you can work with them just as easily as you can on Windows. It doesn't have every single feature that it has on Windows, and it has a Mac-like interface, but it works beautifully and allows you to easily open, edit, and save Word documents and work with people that are on Windows using Word. The big catch is that it's not really free. You have to have a subscription to Microsoft service, just like if you were using it on Windows. But the subscriptions are cheaper than a lot of people think. A personal subscription for a whole year is $70, and that's all you pay. You don't have to spend money if there's a new update, and you always have the latest version of Word. But it is the catch here, and it's the only solution I'm going to show that actually costs money. If you use Word professionally, then this clearly is a solution. But also if you happen to use Word a lot, because you get a lot of documents and people expect you to send them a lot of Word documents, it may be worth the price. But let's say you just don't want to do that. You don't want to get Word. There are tons of other solutions as well. And probably the most used one is to simply use Pages to open these Word documents. Here I've got a bunch of Word documents. Actually, these are templates that I just created and then saved immediately using Word. And I can open them in Pages. So you can get Pages from the App Store as well if you don't already have it. Of course, it's free from Apple. Once you have it installed, you can drag and drop onto Pages in either the app folder or here in the dock. And you can see here you get a warning with elements aren't supported. A lot of times there are things you don't even need. So here this journal example comes out really great. The business letter looks perfect. The newsletter uses a lot of advanced layout, so we're going to see some problems here. But if it's the kind of thing where somebody's sending you a finished newsletter and you just want to read it, then it still works good enough. The research paper here works fine as well. Now, when you're working with a Word document in Pages, you're actually working with a Pages document. So it's converting it to Pages. You're working in Pages now. If I were to go to File, Save, it's not going to just save it out. It's going to ask me to save it as a Pages document. And that's the way to do it if you want to continue working with it on your Mac. Save it as a Pages document. Keep working with it on Pages. But when you need to return this to somebody that doesn't have Pages, say somebody on Windows with Word, then you want to go to File, Export To, and Export to Word. And here you get to choose whether or not you want to use the current format or the much, much older .doc format, and then export it out. And now you are back to a Word format. You can send them that .docx document and they can open it on their Windows machine. Now there are more ways to be able to handle Word documents. There are third-party Office suites, free ones as well. For instance, I have two installed here. One's called OpenOffice and the other's called LibreOffice. I can drag and drop onto those as well. Here's what happens if I drag this onto OpenOffice. It'll open up and it looks really good. Most of these documents do too. Let's look at the newsletter. And you can see that looks pretty good. Not as good as it does in Word. There's some margin problems here, but works pretty well. The other one is LibreOffice. Let's try that one out. And you can see that looks pretty good there. And the newsletter looks very good. So you can download these from their various sites. They're pretty popular Office Suite alternatives. Another option is to use Google Docs. You just go to the docs.google.com webpage. You already have a Google account if you use Gmail. And then you could go to this folder here. It opens a file picker. You can do upload and you could drag a file to it. It will upload a Word document and then convert it to a Google Docs document. And then it opens it up and you've got access to it. Let's try the newsletter example. So it definitely struggles a little with this. You see how it breaks it onto separate pages where it shouldn't, but still readable. Now after you work with it here in Google Docs, you can go to their file menu here and then download. And you see one of the options is to download it as Microsoft Word. Now one more option I want to show you is just simply use TextEdit to open these up. It's not very useful if you're trying to work with somebody, but if somebody sends you a document and it just has text in it and you just want to read it, you don't want to bother with any of this stuff. You already have TextEdit on your Mac. You can drag and drop a Word file to TextEdit and you can at least see the text that's inside. And it works with any Word document except, of course, the page layout ones aren't going to look as great. This newsletter one is going to look horrible. But you do get all of the content in there. Now there is one other way that you could deal with a Word document, but it's only for reading. So this won't allow you to edit or collaborate, but you could just use Quick Look in the Finder. You don't even need to use an app. You could just select the file on the desktop, in a folder, in a Finder window, and just use Command Y or the space bar to bring up Quick Look, and you could see it actually renders out the Word document there with graphics in the Quick Look view. So you can quickly read what's there. It even works if there are multiple pages. You can scroll through it. So in the past when I've written computer books, I've had to use Microsoft Word to collaborate with others who are on Windows machines. But for the most part, I try to use Pages for word processing. And if I do get an occasional Word doc or need to be able to send one, I use Pages to do that. You might find those or maybe one of these other solutions works best for your situation. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.